Hello guys, in this video I'm going to be showing you how I do a special effects makeup using affordable products and mostly cream based products. I'm going to start off doing my base makeup. I'm using an old school product, OCC Lip Tar in the warm purple shade. I'm spreading that all over my face and then blending it out with a Hank and Henry brush. This is one of the only brushes that I kept from the banana set. All the other ones broke on me, but this one's pretty good. So I'm just going to spread out that product easily with my brush. After that is spread it out, I'm going to move on to using another OCC Lip Tar in a very pale pink shade as my highlight. I started off using the Hank and Henry brush again, but it wasn't quite spreading well, so I switched to a Moda Easy Contour brush. The last step of the base before I set it is a contour. So I'm going to be using a contour stick that I made. I got the stick containers off of an Etsy shop. I will link it down below if I remember. This shade in particular I use for my everyday makeup as well. It's more like a purpley gray color, and it can also be used as a blush shade because of if you use it intensely or lightly, and also for brows, and it makes a very good lip color. I really love this color a lot. Now I'm just setting that base with a homemade powder I made, setting powder. It's a combination of Ben Nye's Nutriset, rice powder, and tapioca starch. It's very good. I love it a lot, and I get a lot of it because I make it in a big batch. And also to preserve this powder, I keep the silica packs that you get from new shoes or new clothing, and I put them inside the jar. After my base is all set, I'm just going to take a nabby eye kohl in the shade Black One and just outline over my perimeter of my face where my makeup ends. I'm doing this because I don't want to actually go into my hairline as my braids are freshly done, and this will keep me from getting makeup in my hairline, but make sure that the look still looks complete. Then I'm going to take that same eye kohl and fill in my brows. I'm starting off lightly and then going to build up the color. I'm just doing back and forth strokes until I get the intensity that I want. Then I'm going to shape my brows with a Do Care angled eyebrow brush. I tried using this brush for eyeliner one time, and it was a little bit too stiff, but it works great for eyebrows. So I'm just using that to get my eyebrows in the shape that I want. I'm adding like 2 upward hair strokes just to add a bit more life to this particular look. It will make it a bit more cartoony. Now I'm going to take that same eye kohl and start mapping out how I want my eyeshadow shape to be. I'm going to be focusing on doing a somewhat halo eye, so I'm adding it to the outer corners of my eyes and the inner corners of my eyes as well. Lastly, I'm using that same coal to do a outline of my lips. This will just add some depth when I go in to add my lipstick shade. And I'm also using that same eye coal to intensify my contours. So I'm focusing on the cheeks and the nose contour with this. After that, I'm simply taking a Frankened purple eyeshadow in a matte warm shade and going around my eyes, and I'm also going to be using it as blush and like a bronzery color for this particular look. This Frankened shade was made from a mixture of Juvia's Place eyeshadows and a few colors from the Beauty Bay Disney collaboration, where they did all those palettes for like Dumbo, the Cheshire Cat, and I believe the last one was the Jungle Book collection. And it's a very beautiful shade. I love this shade a lot.
Thank you.
to intensify where I added the first purple shadow, I'm going to be taking another Franken eyeshadow, and this is a saddened, cool-toned dark purple, and it adds a little bit of sheen, not too much, and I'm just going over areas where I feel there should be shadow. So the contour area, the temples of the head, the very outer corner of the eyes, and also this shade was made from a Julia's Place Franken eyeshadow and a mixture of a Saucebox Cosmetic shadow. I'm just going to briefly go over some of the brushes that I've been using. So if you noticed, I'm using a lot of flat shaped brushes to apply my eyeshadows just because I want them to be very intense right off the bat. The brushes that I am using are from Crown Brushes. They are their Sabled Hair brushes, and sable is a natural type of hair that really picks up pigment very, very well. I recommend them to use if you don't want any fallout, because with these particular brushes, I noticed that I don't get any fallout at all, and it just makes my application a lot more neater and gives me the look that I want, so I don't have to worry about cleanup or anything. Thank you. I'm going to be adding another highlight shade. For that, I'm using the Cosette Cosmetics eyeshadow in the shade Umi. I believe that's what this shade is called. It's a duochromed lilac-y pink shade. I feel like it is a lot more pink when you apply it, so I am applying that to the highest points of where I want my highlight to be. And I'm also using, again, a Sabled Hair flat brush. I'm going to be adding another highlight shade. For that, I'm using the Cosette Cosmetics eyeshadow in the shade Umi. I believe that's what this shade is called. It's a duochromed lilac-y pink shade. I feel like it is a lot more pink when you apply it, so I am applying that to the highest points of where I want my highlight to be. And I'm also using, again, a Sabled Hair flat brush. After that's done, I'm going to be finally working on my under eye area. So I'm just going to be adding some depth and the same purple shadows that I used on my lower eye area. intensify the lower eye area, I am going in with that same black eye coal in the shade Black One by Nabby, just to intensify that area. Lastly, I'm going in with a tiny shaped sable haired brush to add in the final highlighting details, and I'm using the shade Umi again by Cosette, and just highlighting the inner corner, the very tip of my nose, tip of my cheekbones, and my Cupid's bow, and a little bit around my lips. Lastly, to finish off this very cool look, I'm taking some Scandinavia setting spray, spraying it on the back of my hand, and using a angled Moda brush, applying the brush to the setting spray on my hand, and simply just easily dabbing it around my face instead of spraying it directly. Because I want to show you a way that your makeup can really last. If you apply it this way versus just spraying it from the bottle, it's going to really hold up and last a lot. This can be also used for conventions and even like setting sparkly eyeshadows that you apply so you don't get any fallout. Alright guys, so that's about it for this tutorial. I'm just going to briefly go over what I used. So I used about 9 makeup brushes, 1 Kohl eye pencil in Black One, about 4 eyeshadows. Yeah, it was 4 in total. A OCC Lip Tar purple shade and an OCC Lip Tar light pink shade, and just a setting powder that I made. And the reason I use so few products is that I want to show you that you can get very, very good makeup like done, but with less products, because there's so many tutorials out there where they use so many products and so many brushes and have all of these tools and everything. And I want to show you that you don't need all of that to get started and to feel like confident in your makeup application. It's all about technique and knowing what works good for your particular face shape. So again, thank you so much for watching my first SFX tutorial, and I can't wait to see you soon. Love you all.